बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ फर्स्ट ईयर एमबीबीएस, लेट मी शो यू द स्लाइड ऑफ द स्किन। एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट द स्किन कंसिस्ट ऑफ द एपिडर्मस एंड द डर्मस। दिस इज़ द एपिडर्मस एंड दिस इज़ द डर्मस। द एपिडर्मस एज यू कैन सी दिस इज़ एन एपिथीलियम। दिस इज़ स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्केमस क्रेटिनाइज्ड एपिथीलियम and stratified squamous keratinized epithelium consists of many layers of the cells. This is the stratum basal towards the basal side. This is the basal lamina. So this stratified squamous epithelium consists of many layers. There is stratum basal or stratum germinativum, then the stratum spinosum, the stratum granulosum, stratum corneum. This is the stratum corneum, the corneocytes, which are the dead cells, and there is deposition of a protein which is filamentous, and filaments are deposited in the iliadine, which is a substance which is secreted by the an amorphous material secreted by the keratohyaline granules present in the stratum granulosum. So this is the epidermis. And can you see the epidermis is dipping down into the dermis, and it gives rise to the, this is a tubular sheath which encloses the root of the hair, and this is called the hair follicle. And hair follicle is one of the identification points of the thin skin. The thin skin is hairy skin. The thick skin, that is the skin of the palms and soles, that is non-hairy. And then we have already seen that there are two layers of the dermis, the papillary layer and the reticular layer. Here lies the papillary layer. These are the papillae, these are known as the dermal papillae. This is actually the loose areolar connective tissue, and these ridges are known as the papillae. And these papillae, they may be the nervous papillae or the vascular papillae. If there is a nerve fiber present inside, this is the nervous papilla, and if there is a blood vessel. And as regards the this broader zone, this is the broader zone which is in which are lying the hair follicles, in which are lying the other accessories of the skin, that is the sebaceous gland and the sweat glands. That is the reticular layer of the dermis, dense irregular connective tissue. So this is the slide of the skin. Here you can see this is the sebaceous gland, and these are the sweat glands. Can you see the sebaceous gland? In the lining of the sebaceous gland, you can see a multi-layered epithelium. This is because of the fact that the sebaceous glands are holocrine glands. So in the secretion, that is the sebum, that is oily secretion which is produced in these alveoli, this is simple alveolar branched gland. So in the alveoli, the lining is just like the epidermis, that is the basal layer, and then the cells just like those of the stratum spinosum and stratum granulosum, and these cells disintegrate along with an oily secretion into the duct of the gland, and this duct is opening into the hair follicle. So these are the sebaceous glands, and can you see this? These are the sweat gland, the simple tubular coiled glands are the sweat glands. Again, this is the hair follicle present in the reticular layer of the, so this is the slide of the skin. Now you can see this is the slide of the palatine tonsil. You can see there are the lymphatic nodules. This is a typical lymphatic nodule which has got a lightly stained area in the center, that is the germinal center, and this is the cortex. This is the cortex. The very darkly stained cells, that is the small lymphocytes. And I have told you that this is the tonsil is the palatine tonsil. This is actually the palatine tonsil, and the palatine tonsils are the organs which are present in between the anterior and posterior fascial pillars in the buccal cavity. And palatine tonsils, when we cut a section, we will find that there is only an incomplete connective tissue capsule on the posterior side, that is the tonsillar bed, and it is covered by stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, which is heavily infiltrated with the lymphocytes. And that posterior capsule sends the septa. These are the septa. The septa which divide this tonsillar tissue into smaller compartments. And on both sides of the septum, there are the diffuse and nodular type of lymphatic tissue. This is the stratified squamous epithelium, which is a moist type of epithelium and non-keratinized, covering the surface of the tonsil and heavily infiltrated with the lymphocytes. And these are the lymphatic nodules. This is lymph node. Lymph node, I have told you that lymph node, when we see a section of the lymph node is surrounded by a connective tissue capsule, which sends this trabeculi or septa inside. This is the trabeculi. And it is further divided into the medulla and the cortex. Towards the convex side, there is a convex side and there is a concave. It is a bean-shaped structure. It is a kidney-like structure. And the indentation or the concavity on one side is the hilum of the lymph node. The lymph node is, when we see under the microscope, it consists of the medulla and the cortex. These are the cortical nodules. Towards the capsule, we will see the typical nodular type of lymphatic tissue in the form of these cortical nodules, because they are present in the cortex. And trabeculum, on both sides of the trabeculi, this space is called the, this is the cortical sinus. So there are sinuses in the lymph node, because lymph node is a filtration plant and lymph is passing through, it is percolating through the lymph node, and it is filtered when it passes through the cortical sinuses, the medullary sinuses. And this is the capsule, and this capsule sends the septa inside, and this is the cortical nodule. Now this is the spleen. You can see the spleen is also covered by the connective tissue capsule, but when we see the substance of the spleen, we will find that there are nodular structures, which is known as, here it is called the white pulp, and this is the red pulp, which consists of the cords which are made up of all the types of cells. There are lymphocytes, there are plasma cells, the erythrocytes, leukocytes, and these lymphatic nodules, which are also known as the Malpighian body or the Malpighian corpuscles, they have got a very characteristic feature, that through these lymphatic nodules, that is the splenic nodules, passes an artery which is known as the central artery. This is the central artery, but you can see this artery is passing eccentrically. It avoids the germinal center. Here lies the germinal center, and artery is passing on the side of the germinal center. So this is the characteristic feature of the splenic nodule. And splenic nodules are known as the white pulp. And the remainder of the pulp is the red pulp. And red pulp is consisting of the cords of Willroth. And in between these cords, there are splenic sinusoids, which contain the blood. So spleen is a big hemolymph organ. This is the, can you see, this is the germinal center, this is a splenic nodule, here lies the splenic artery. This is actually an arteriole. This is an arteriole and it passes through the splenic nodule or the Malpighian body, and it is present eccentrically. So this is the collection of the lymphocytes, and these are the cords of Billroth.